The Raspberry Pi has a variety of use cases. We've covered a few before. It can be used to stream your Steam games, turn your speaker into an AirPlay speaker, and much more. But this time we're going to take a look into retro emulation and turn the Pi into a retro gaming machine with RetroPie. RetroPie allows you to turn your Raspberry Pi or any Debian or Ubuntu based machine into a retro gaming console. RetroPie can be installed onto an existing Raspbian installation, but for this tutorial I'm going to be showing you how to get started with pre-made images. For this tutorial you're going to need to have a few programs downloaded onto your computer, so you're going to need 7-zip or another archiving file manager and Etcher to write the image to the SD card. Previously I've used Win32 Disk Imager, but I think Etcher is a nicer program to use. So the first step to get started will be to download the pre-made RetroPie image from the RetroPie website. So there will be links for everything in the description, and there's also a full write-up of this tutorial if you want to read it. So you want to go to the RetroPie website and download the image. So you're going to want to pick the appropriate version. If you don't know which one you have, you can boot up your Raspberry Pi into Raspbian, and depending on how many Raspberry icons you see will be which one you need to download. So if you see one Raspberry icon, get the Raspberry Pi 0/1, and if you have four icons for the Raspberry Pi 2 and 3, you want to download this one. But since I have the original Raspberry Pi, I'm going to be downloading this one here. So I just recommend saving it to your desktop for simplicity, and I will be right back once this is downloaded. Alright, so now that it is downloaded, we have the file here, and we just need to unzip this. What you can do is just open it up and then just drag the image file out onto your desktop. So now that we have the image file extracted, we just need to write it to the Raspberry Pi's SD card, and then we can boot up into RetroPie. So this is where Etcher comes in, so we're going to just open it up. And now we want to select the image. So click select image and then just click the Raspberry Pi image there. And now you want to get your Raspberry Pi SD card and make sure that's plugged into your computer. And you'll want to make sure that there's nothing on this SD card that you want to keep, because writing the image will wipe the card. So you just want to click change here to make sure that you've got the right device selected to write to, because you don't want to write to the wrong one. And then once you've double checked that, just click continue and then you can click flash. Click yes to anything that might pop up, and there you go. It's going to start writing the image to the SD card, and then once it's done, we will put the SD card into the Pi and continue from there. So now that the SD card is written, put it into your Raspberry Pi, and I'd recommend a wired controller or also a USB Wi-Fi adapter if you're going to be putting the Pi somewhere that doesn't have Ethernet, or if you have a Raspberry Pi 3, it already has Wi-Fi built in. So now we're just starting up RetroPie for the first time. It's just going to configure a few things, and then it's going to take us to the controller configuration screen. Alright, so now we're at the welcome screen. You just want to hold a button on your controller or keyboard. If you're going to be using a keyboard, you'll want to configure that how you want. But if you're going to be using a controller, we're just going to be using the suggestions and following the diagram that RetroPie has created, which I will show all three of them on the screen. Just pause on the appropriate one, or they're also in the article. So I'm just going to configure this now. Now you can see if you missed one, just keep going. It's a bit finicky. Now I'm just going to go back up and do the one that I missed. There. There we go. And press OK. There are a few hotkeys that you'll want to know, which I'll show on the screen as well. Probably the most important ones that you're going to want to remember are the exiting and save shortcuts. So start and select for exiting, and select and right shoulder for save. As with the retro games and consoles, autosave wasn't exactly a thing, as ROMs are read-only memory, and to exit the game you would turn off the console. So for emulation you want to remember those. So now I'm going to show you how to set up Wi-Fi. If you don't want to use Wi-Fi, just skip to the time shown on the screen. But if you do want to use Wi-Fi, so you can use Wi-Fi to transfer games to your Pi, we can configure it in a few ways. So if you have a keyboard, you want to go to the configuration on RetroPie, go down to Wi-Fi, and then you want to go on to connect to Wi-Fi network, and then you want to select your Wi-Fi network and put in the password. Or if you don't have a keyboard plugged in, you can create a text file on the SD card, which is going to be the method that I'm going to personally use. So what you want to do is turn off the Raspberry Pi and then take out the SD card and put it back into your computer. So now that the SD card is plugged into the computer, you want to ignore any formatting messages like this. So just click cancel. Then you want to open up Notepad, and then we need to put the Wi-Fi network info into the text document. So you want to type this in, but replace network name with the name of your network, and then replace network password with the password of your network. And then you want to save this file to the boot partition of the SD card, which should show up here. And then you just want to save the text file as wifikeyfile.txt. And then click save, and then you can close this and unplug your SD card and boot up the Pi again. Okay, so now the Pi has been booted up again with the SD card. You want to go to the RetroPie configuration, go down to Wi-Fi, and then you want to go on to import Wi-Fi credentials from boot/winkeyfile.txt. It will connect, and there you go. So then you can go onto exit, and now we can get to the good part, which is actually transferring the ROMs to the Pi itself. So first of all, you want to make sure that the ROMs that you're planning to copy over are actually compatible. So you want to check the supported systems list, but I won't be showing you how to get ROMs yourself, but Google is definitely your friend. There are a few ways to transfer ROMs to the Pi: USB, SFTP and SMB, but for this tutorial, I shall be showing you the USB and SMB methods. So we'll get started with USB transfer. And what you're going to want to do is, because it's relatively simple, you want to create a folder on your USB stick called RetroPie and plug it into your Raspberry Pi. And if your USB stick has a light on it, you want to wait for the light to stop flashing as RetroPie sets up the folders that you can copy to. If it doesn't have a light, give it a minute or so, or five if you want to be safe, or use another transfer method. So once that's done, you can unplug the USB from the Pi and plug it back into your computer. And then you can copy the ROMs to their respective folders in RetroPie ROMs. So SNES ROMs, for example, would go in the SNES folder and so on. Once the copying is done, unplug the USB stick from the computer and plug it back into the Raspberry Pi. It's now going to copy all the ROMs onto the Pi's SD card. And once again, the light is finished flashing, you can unplug it. As before, if you don't have a light on the USB stick, just give it plenty of time for everything to copy over. Now you can restart Emulation Station by pressing F4 on the keyboard if you have a keyboard plugged in, or if you're using a controller, press Start and then go down to Quit and then choose Restart Emulation Station. SMB transfer, or Samba, I think is much simpler and easier than the USB transfer method. Your computer and Raspberry Pi will both need to be connected to the same network via Ethernet or Wi-Fi, and that's all you need. So open up Windows Explorer and type in /, and then RetroPie, and then this will take you to the RetroPie folders. And then if you just go onto ROMs, you can see all of the different folders that there are. We are going to be putting a ROM in the Atari 2600 box folder, as a Pac-Man's probably a lot easier to play on the Pi than going up into the loft and getting the Atari out the loft. So that's what we'll do, and that's all you need to do to copy a ROM over. That's it, it's already on the Pi, it's sorted. If you're on a Mac, you'd open up Finder and you'd go onto the Go bar at the top of the screen and go onto Connect to Server, and then you'd put SMB:// and then RetroPie and do exactly the same. Now you can restart Emulation Station again by pressing F4 on the keyboard, or Start on your controller and then go to the Quit option and restart Emulation Station. And that's it. You now have a retro gaming console which you can play all your favorite classics on. Some of the games may not run at full speed depending on how old your Pi is and if you have overclocked it or not. So 3D games may struggle, but 2D titles should run just fine. But that's been it for this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.